Morning, gang. Oh dear. Another cold morning for us tradies. Now, repointing a patio on this job. It's got an old York stone paving. I'm going to be repointing it, so I'm going to be using my mortar gun. Which applies the muck to the joint, but you'll see that later on in the video. See how I load the gun, how I squeeze it out, and then the sort of finish it leaves, the amount to put in the joint, and then we're troweling it off probably 10-15 minutes later, just with a little pointing trowel. And the finish on this one's a little bird peak joint, so it's like a little pointed joint between all the slabs. And now the gauge we're doing for this is 3 building sand to 1 part cement. So you can use a trowel, you can use a shovel. Just make sure you keep the shovel falls or the trowel falls the same size every time, because you don't want to be altering the colour. So you want to be making sure it's the same size every time. This particular one, I've used my normal brick trowel and done 6 trowelfuls of sand, 2 trowelfuls of cement, adding water, and then plenty of this Fed Bomb PVA. And I'm basically taking over. There was an old boy who actually started this job, ground all the joints out, started repointing, but it's quite tough. You're on your hands, you're on your knees. It's not nice, and for the older generation, it's hard going. It really is. So bless him, he's said to the client that I'm gonna have to stop. Are you able to get someone else to finish? And they did the right thing, and they called PH Paving and Brickwork. So we're in, we're taking over. The gentleman's told me the mix. He was doing a 3-in-1 with plenty of his PVA in the water when he mixed it. So that was kind of him to tell me the ratio, because sometimes when you take over from jobs and it's all like the builder before, they've left on bad terms, and then a new builder comes in and needs to know for colour matching purposes what the ratio is. Sometimes if you can't get hold of that previous builder, then it's a nightmare, because then you're guessing at what the colour is. But anything repointing, if you're putting sand and cement in the ground, I would always go 3-in-1. Brick and block work, I'll go 4-in-1 below damp. But for this, for patios, 3-in-1 all day long. So yeah, I've just mixed up some muck now. So in there, it's not as wet as bricklayer muck, but it's not really dry. I need it quite wet, because I need it to be able to squeeze out of my mortar gun, but you'll see that later on in the video. So I'm gonna take all this round the back now and get started. Earlier on, I said about use of a mortar gun. Now, I've made a start. Started putting the muck in the joints, but I'm going to show you now how I load the mortar gun. Some people might say taking the top end off, which I take that off. Basically, in there is a big plunger. And then as you push it down, you push, the muck comes out the other end, out of the nozzle. Now, I don't take that off every time. I take the nozzle off, and then make sure the handle's pulled right down. And with the handle pulled down, you can then put the muck in the top, like this. So I'll take my trowel, just a little bucket trowel, give it a little shake, thread off with your fingers, ideally with gloves on. Screw the nozzle on like so. So now you're ready to go. Now don't go pushing this in until you're ready to put it in the joint, because otherwise you'll make a right mess. Right, so now I've showed you how to fill the gun, I'm going to show you how to use it. So I'm going to put this in some of the joints. Don't go pushing too hard. It's all about pushing the plunger down but moving the mortar gun itself at the right times. If you push too much and don't move quick enough, it spills out and you end up with a pile of muck on the slabs. But if you don't, if you move too fast and don't push quick enough, you end up with not enough in the joints. It's about getting them timings right. It takes a little bit of playing around with, but you get there in the end. So, as you see, that's ready to come out now. And we're just going to run along the joint, right side. The gun, and it don't push out anymore because the plunger only comes to here. So obviously you end up with the nozzle left full of muck. Now the way to get over that is pull the plunger up so it fills up with air, and then push it out. And then as you push the plunger down, the air pushes, the trapped air pushes the last of the muck out of the nozzle. And then you fill up again, go again. And it's a lot easier than just being on your hands and knees. I used to be on my hands and knees. I used to do it with dry mix. I used to use a little six inch bit of feather edge, compacting it all in and then running over it with the iron. Constantly on your hands and knees. This way, you're on your feet, you're not getting as cold. But the use of a mortar gun definitely works wonders. So this is the horrible bit. On your hands and knees. You've got to try and get yourself as comfy as possible using a knee pad. It just helps on the knees a little bit. I mean, you're still down on your hands and knees, nothing you can do about it, but it just protects your knees a little bit. So with using the mortar gun, you can see now mortar's all in the joints. I'm just going to go through. I'm using a pointing trowel, and all we're doing is this part of the trowel is running down on the inside edge of this slab, and the underside of the trowel on the opposite side is running against the top of this. So you're in at that angle, and all you do is run along the joint, and then you need to run along it a couple of times, just making sure any excess muck that comes up, you just even it out, spread it along. Don't want any lift of muck going up on the edge of the slab. So that's that side. Let's take the top off. And all we're going to do now is the same along the other edge. Now I just push it away a little bit from the slab so it doesn't come up on top, and then I run along. That's giving you a nice bird beak finish. But like I said, you have to go over it a few times. But once you've done that and you're happy with it, you then leave it, move along. What I'll do is I'll pick the camera and show you what's just happened, and what I've just done. I'll show you this little bit, because what's happening, so that now is the joint, but what's happening here, where you meet, that needs to be nice. So what I'm going to do is just sort of bring it round the corner.
On air, online, on
your phone, you can see that. I might be able to see what you're seeing at the minute. Just pull that round the corner.
Questions again over the weather and Christmas party took place in Downing Street last year when the guidance was to avoid them. The Prime Minister has already denied the event, but a leaked video appears to show Stephen Downing Street staff joking about one. Since the footage came to light, the
house that little joy dump. Time consuming, yes. But does it look good? Yes. So it's worth it. It does look good when you're done. Now I'll stand up, I'll show you something I've already done.
All our slots is set to take office as Germany's ninth post-war chancellor. He succeeded Angela Merkel after her 16-year tenure. The parents of the 97th Hillsborough victim say they're proud as he's due to be awarded the freedom of Liverpool. 55-year-old
Andrew died in July. I did this little bit yesterday.
And Avanti West Coast has modified its website to help disabled passengers. That's the latest from Radio.
So that's yesterday. Now, I reckon I've got today and a little bit of tomorrow morning. Just finishing this patio. I'll put some pictures on as well, but hopefully you get the gist of what I'm doing. So it's pointing trowel to do the joint, to get a bird beak finish, but mortar gun to apply them up to the joint. And I'm putting in as a like a semi-wet mix. As long as it pushes through your mortar gun, then you're good to go.